Yo, Mike, what's up? We're live, by the way. Let me make sure. Oh, shit. You know what? I don't have my mic set up right. All right. Can you hear me now? Oh, shit. You know what? I also don't have this set up. Alright, no. My mic's good. And okay, I think I'm good. Super impromptu exhibitions coming up today. We got two FT10s. We'll see where it goes.
Alright, so who's gonna be up first?
Yo, what up, Mike? How's it going?
Everything's all right.
Cool.
Rain's died out over here. Yo. First day of the fair. Probably try to get out of here if these guys don't take too long killing each other.
Well, we have two nice FT10s. I'm familiar with some of the players just based on previous online tournaments that we've done. Maximus plays Rue from the United States. I'm not sure about their regions. It'd be nice to know, but I guess what I can do is look at his ping. His ping to me is like 25 to 30, so maybe he's, you know, West Coast. Hell, maybe he's even California. And he's in a fight against thecolortechnic, who I believe plays Blanka. And we already know hyperfighting Blanka is a completely different kind of beast. Also, it's a very low ping, 17, about 20 MS. So I think they're both same region, so that's kind of hype. And so it's going to be classic Rue versus Gilly. Or sorry, Rue versus Blanka, and then after that we're gonna have a good match. So I don't know if you're familiar with H0.
No, I'm not.
But he is a really strong super turbo player from Mexico. He got himself an arcade cabinet and he streams a bunch of stuff. He got bit by the hyper fighting bug at one point or another during the pandemic, and He was kind of the undefeated player for a long time until Deep Focus finally beat him in one of the tournaments. And there was a bounty. There was a $100 bounty, I think, for that, that Turbo Annihilator put up. And so it took 8-0 like six tournaments to finally lose. So he got knocked out and we were able to finally crown a new champion.
This is a random question. Is that the same guy that throws a tournament in Mexico? Because I got invited like, I think, 10, 12 years ago, something like that, to some get-together. It was like a more of a get-together at a big house. It wasn't like an arcade or anything, but just wondering if that was the same group.
If it was 10 years ago, it might have been DJ Friolis who invited you, but no, A0 does a lot for organizing online and, you know, some of the offline stuff, but like you said, it's more, you know, they call them gatherings rather than like a major or a tournament.
Right.
Yeah, why am I Bipson so faded up there? Hold up. He's super faded. Let me bring him back.
All about presentation, bro. Can't be bringing in more people looking at ugly stuff like this. Come on, man.
Bro, I haven't had time to do, like... Hold on, let's bump. Yeah, there you go. That Bipson looks more healthy. Yeah, that's better. But no, I didn't even get to, I didn't even get to change any of the artwork or nothing since the last stream. Like, that's even Alpha 3 artwork. It's not even Hyper Fighting artwork. Sorry, guys. I've been busy, so...
Hey, Street Fighter, dude. We'll deal with it.
Nah, hold on. I'm going to switch the art real quick. Yeah, don't let me... Yeah. We'll leave
it blank. Did you read the Discord earlier today? The stories about colors and people being bitchy about, oh, you can't pick my color, bro. I can't play without my color.
Nah, I didn't really pay attention to any of that. Yo, if you guys want to... If you guys have time on your hands and you want to do some reading, like, join the Hyper Fighting Discord. It's discord.gg. Oh, shit. I didn't even update the link. Come on, man. I'm so behind. Hold on. I actually was the one that updated. So I updated the Discord link on the actual server. So it's discord.gg/SF2HF. Very easy to remember. But on my own stream, I don't have it right. What a scrub. This is why Mike Watson doesn't want me to stream anything at Reloaded. But you guys are all welcome to go and you know, still check out the dope matches that'll take place out there. There goes your
guys, please come to 37 Reloaded so you can all slap Rizwan around and wake him up and
wake me
teach
up.
Him how to get his shit together.
Nah,
poor
for war. Nah, for real. I mean, my goal out there, obviously, like, I'm going to be going as a competitor. You guys have not seen me as a competitor in a hot minute. You know, I don't really compete anymore. But I'm going to go enter a few games since, you know, I don't really have to, like, stream anything there. And obviously, I'll help with TOing and just making sure that the event, like, I got to do my part to make sure that the retro stuff is held down. And I do want to have like exhibitions, whether they're hotel exhibitions or like interviews, is kind of happening on the spot. But yeah, you can expect like random chill stuff happening that weekend. And of course, this is the celebration of retro. So, you know, these past 2-3 years, it's been doing all the stuff online, and I feel like a lot of people will show up because this is going to be the retro major of the year.
This might be the only time you ever see me and Troy play too, so.
Yep.
Come and get your popcorn ready.
Yeah, so it's going to be, I always say, it's one for the books, and, you know, this is a unique, very rare opportunity to get some good matches, but not only about the matches, just, I think the people that will be there, just to be able to see each other, whether it's your first tournament or, you know, you've been to many, and you're like, yeah, whatever, this is normal for me, but... Yeah, definitely want to encourage everyone. Don't miss out. Don't regret it later if you're like, oh, man, I really should have gone. Just go, you know. And
go. The price is cheap. You don't have to pay $100 for no day of finals bullshit. You don't have to pay no $80 registration free nonsense. You're paying $50 for 2 days for regular registration. Doesn't get much better than that, man.
Yeah. So, in any case, I think they're ready to get into the first match, so I will do what we normally do, which is share my screen to you, and...
I can pop on Fight K. That's probably up to the second timing, right?
It'll be close, but Wait, what?
How do I turn off the volume on that shit, though? Jesus.
Hold on. Wait, what? What happened to my fight gate volume? Oh, it's muted. Damn, they already. I guess they started. I guess they're like, here screw you. Man. They're like, screw you guys. Screw your hall pass. All right, I'm gonna share the Are you big into movies, by the way? Like, do you watch
Definitely.
A lot of movies? All right, cool.
Ton. Too many sometimes.
Alright, Maximus getting the first round there. Let me get predictions in the chat, too. Yeah, they're definitely starting on time. I gotta do Family Man stuff after this anyway, so I respect it. Because I don't have time like I used to. But yeah, the match is available for you on Discord, sir. And we'll put up, you know what, we'll put up a 5-minute prediction. I'll let you guys, we'll let it simmer a little bit. So what are your thoughts on this match? How do you feel? Blanka Roo.
Oh, as everybody knows, I'm a Blanka... Not a Blanka fan, but I give Blanka a lot of respect in this game. This guy's playing pretty well. He's keeping him in the corner, jumping neutral, standing short to keep him in place, not giving him a chance to breathe. So it's a tough match. He dishes out a lot of damage. Ryu has the stun factor, of course, which is what everybody focuses on. They keep saying, "Oh, if you trade fireballs, you're gonna get dizzy." But once again, if you got the timing down, you trade with one fierce look. He's blocking a few fireballs, just walking forward safely. Could have jumped with the jump strong to hit his roundhouse there, because grip guard's really not consistent against Blanka in this match. He just has so many neutrals that'll just jack you up.
Ah, I got him with the Tatsu grab.
But yeah, I don't like this match for the fact that I think Blanka controls this match. In order to win, you gotta sit there, you gotta be patient, and I like to hit buttons, I like to do stuff, so it's kind of test your patience a lot in this match.
Yeah,
and then
100%
he can turn on any second too, because he's a pretty fast character with his ball and little gimmicks. So he controls the pace of the match indefinitely. But
wow, what a walk up bite there from Color Technic. Nice, he's gonna get a setup here. He goes for the safe stuff. Yeah, Color Technic is pretty solid with the Blanka from what I've seen so far. Look at that, killing the fireball on start of it. Here's the tick throw, boys and girls.
So after he eats a fireball, he's chilling, waiting for his stun to go down, which is a perfect play.
Okay, it's another sweep. And any trade will do it, but a tick throw. Yep, sweep fireball. Crouch fierce trade will also do it, so Color Technic looking for it. Oh, and a jump medium punch for the win.
A little bit risky there. I think the guy actually tried to uppercut because he did leave the ground, so it might have been a missed input, but regardless.
Guys, bet your damn channel points. Bet all of them. I still see them at zero.
Hey, Blanka.
It's an FT10. Oh, it's stun. Yep, anything would have stunned there. Boom, boom. Oh, nice three-piece from the front. No specials, though. That's like when your joystick is messed up and you just want to play the safe combo.
Right? He's got the Mexican uppercut on deck.
Nice air to air.
Perfect air-to-air roundhouse. You don't see that very often anymore, so you know this guy's been doing his homework.
Yeah, it's interesting as well because, you know, compared to CE... Oh, nice anti-air and the cross under. What a guard for Maximus. But, yeah, compared to CE and a nice shorty there. I'm just trying to talk, but I can't. These guys are playing real good right now. Dalton, Blanka's jump-ins got much better compared to Champion Edition, especially his jump medium punch. It's much harder to anti-air. So you have to use uppercut as opposed to a normal, and so good on Max.
So how do these colors work, man? I'm watching on Fightcade and it's normal color. I'm watching on your shit and it's like all this
I got a color mod. I got a color mod. That's why. So you see my color mod because that's what I'm sharing. Wow, and a tick throw. That was kind of dirty and risky, but we take those. 1-1.
So we're definitely seeing some solid fundamentals on both sides. You got Blanka with his good range, you got Ryu, you know, playing his fireball uppercut game pretty much to perfection at the moment. Downstrong stuffing the normal, but yeah, Colors is he's hitting his low roundhouses pretty well. He's telegraphing a lot of stuff, so.
Yeah, especially with the walk-up sweep, because it'll actually blow up low strong. So Ryu wants that low strong to counter poke, but, you know, sweep will beat that up. Oh, he got the cross-up and a stun, and just throw him or two-piece him. Still goes for the three.
So I don't know if you remember or not, but I think the whole turning point in the match in round two, or the second match, is when he tried to get fancy and he did like some ball antics and balled behind him when he had him in the corner already.
Yep. And he put
See, boys and girls, don't get too fancy, boys and girls. That's all I'm gonna tell you. That cost him literally the whole match, and if he loses this game, he basically went from being up 2-0 to down 2-1 just because of one move. Just it just totally changes the outlook and the whole mood of the match. So no need for super fancy stuff. Wow, that hurt. See, that's the bullshit damage that Blanka does, man.
Yeah, his like ball this. His ball is like an uppercut in, you know, some way, shape, or form. Nice crushing leg kicks here.
I like he's changing it up a little bit. But I still think he should go back to what he was doing in round one. See, that's what we're talking about. The trip card does not work fully against Blanka because his limbs are just so ranged and he's not gonna be able to get him. I do like him doing that jump roundhouse though. That's like that's really, really an old school tactic. There we go.
Right. There's a question for you in the chat. There's a question for you in the chat from Amazing Return.
Alpha 3 tournament. Did you all know it was gonna be the last mate? We didn't know. We had no idea, and then it was one of those things where, wow, like I think we were all surprised. There was no real warning. I forgot how much notice we got, but it was so crazy. So you got Daigo basically hiding in the office for the whole weekend watching everybody play. That was something I thought was kind of unfair. He never showed up. He never came out to play casuals with anyone. It was like he was just sitting in the office the whole time, and then when it was time to play, the Japanese news crew came out. And then they shook hands. They made Vi wear like a kimono, I guess. And it was kind of embarrassing for him because this guy's like always wearing a stupid wife beater, which was his outfit of choice back in the day. But it was just really weird. And Vi even got screwed over really hard because it was supposed to be, what, like first to three or something like that. And then I think Daigo won one, Vi won one, Daigo barely won. And
I read just the stories about that where it was supposed to be like a format, like Japanese format, US format. And I feel like that topic got kind of talked to death and nice, but the event itself, like it looks cool from a spectator's point of view, and the Valle Daigo matches were actually really hype and still hold up. It's like you could tell the rivalry, you know, between them was just like insane from the beginning, the first international rivalry, right?
If you watch that thing, it's like it's one of the most like how would you say it? It shows the adaptiveness of Vi, the intelligence and the level to be able to recognize certain things that you've never seen before and actually figure out how to counter them on the fly, you know? And I think that might not even be the best case of that, because you got Choi versus Vi at a B3, was it?
Oh,
that's probably the original match that's actually recorded and documented, where you see Choi totally adapting and then using Vi's tactic against him to beat him at one point. So
That's some of the most incredible Street Fighter, actually, that their Alpha 2 match.
It's like really hard to recognize if you're not a good player, but once you're at the better level, like most of you guys are that play all the time, you'll recognize like the brilliance in it, you know. It's just if you can steal someone's moves and you can learn something just so quickly and use it against them, that's a big problem, and that just shows greatness. And Choi's a great player, so.
Yeah, just to get back into this match right now, the color technic making got clipped right there. He tried a low profile to jump and couldn't quite get the grab, but yeah, color technic now mixing it up a lot more. Maximus not able to defend on them. Use the Tatsu to throw. Yeah, these guys are going in right now. There goes that jump strong, very buffed up jump strong compared to CE. Gonna use the ball follow up to grab. Baits it that time. You saw Maximus went for a reversal throw with the medium punch, and that's it. Oh no, it's not it. 50-50 time. Oh, he missed the fireball. He missed something.
One thing I'm not a big fan of, Colors is playing real well, right? Like, obviously, Maximus is playing good too, but he keeps taking these risks when he has, like, the game in hand, and he has him in the corner. He needs to keep him in the corner, guys. Like, he's playing so well, but he's, like, taking a risk to style, or I don't know if it's a bad habit or whatnot. I'm just going to chalk it up to he just wants to look good and beat him with the
And X64 with a big sub. Appreciate you, and good luck at Fight Kingdom this weekend. Nice Dragon Punch. But yeah, to your point, definitely, right? Like, because you can win, you know, with that mix-up, but that's also, you know, an invitation to potentially lose, and you don't want that. That was kind of funky. But that's an invitation to lose, and you, in Street Fighter, you just want to go with whatever's the most guaranteed. You know, it's like poker where you try to play hand based on like percentages and, you know, balance out the risk reward. This game, like, you can't take those huge risks when now you're gonna put yourself in a corner and you might be donezo. It's working out so far for Colortechnic, of course, but again, you're just leaving yourself open to potentially lose. Got the air hurricane.
Well, that's really hard to time too. So that was a really good guess by him.
Uh oh, missed a jump in there. Got the Shoryu, and he needs this cross up, but stays in the front end, gets to confirm. Very nice.
I don't think you can even safe jump Blanka ever. He should be able to like up ball him every single time.
Yeah,
every single jump in.
Here we go. Yep, walk up height. Damn, that's five height.
Once you get in the corner, it's so tough. He's just gonna just pop you and pop you. Wow, that fierce scene. There he goes. He stuck himself in the corner again. Not a big fan. Has a 50% life lead.
Yep. But I mean, he got out of it. So, Max. Oh, wow. What a whiff. That was sick. Nah, that was kind of cute.
You want style? They're just style, bro.
And
the
wedgie.
Style points right there.
Hit him with the wedgie for the win. And a 55.
It's getting to be a little bit of a landslide. Maximus was showing us some promise out there. Come on, bro.
Yeah, come on, man. You were looking Maximus at the beginning. Now you're looking like Minimus. Come through, bro.
There's no disses coming from me, man. This is all Riz one. Just letting you know. Don't want to get confused. I'm not the a-hole here. Alright, so Ryu's back in the corner. What you want to do here is just probably play a little patient. Down strong, and then go for a jump hurricane kick or roundhouse hurricane kick. Just as desperation.
Alright, here we go. Goes for the deep jump and a reversal throw, and that's it. Oh no, no punish. Yeah.
Yeah, that could have ended ugly, but still glitched it out.
So that's one really important thing to note against Blanka. Even if you hit him crouching, like, the Sand Fierce is gonna whiff. So you have to be very mindful of what combo you're doing on Blanka. Don't go for the TPS chain if they're crouching. You gotta make sure they're standing to make that fierce hit.
Man, this guy's really good with that low roundhouse. I give him mad props for that.
Nice anti-air, low fierce, air to air, low jab throw.
Yeah, so Colors is super good with the low roundhouse. Maximus is doing like a really great job with the air to air roundhouse with Ryu. So they both have their, they both definitely have their strengths on the shows.
Alright, big jump and a trade. Bates doesn't get the punish, but nice guard on the Shoryu. Crouch
fierce. Look at how much these fierces do. It's just painful.
Yo, Okamoto Kitchen, what's up? Are you gonna be at a... What the hell was that? Uh-oh. Mix-up time. Close to chip damage now. And he waits. No sweep there.
He's just waiting to sock him in the nut. Uh-oh.
Three-piece him. No, that's not gonna... Yeah. I can't believe the damage on that. Okay, so the highest damage combo that you can do from the front is a jump, fierce, or a roundhouse, and then a low strong or stand strong, basically a medium into Shoryu. So that's the ideal three piece that you want on Blanka. I can't believe that killed. RNG was blessed. Nice bait.
You know, all those times Adrian got burned by the Yoga Flame doing one pixel.
Yeah, right? Remember
Ryu
that?
Ryu stole all of the RNG from him.
Yeah, Okamoto Kitchen, are you going to be at Reloaded?
His kitchen might be a Reloaded. They're trying to work something out right now.
Yeah, that'll be hype. Yes, let's go.
Might have some hyper-fighting Blanka train drinks or something special made up.
I'm trying to get some boba.
You ain't trying to get no boba, dude. Come on.
Boba legend out here.
You need to get some curry.
I'm down for that, too. Nice Shoryu.
What's the curry called again, Gerald? Ofu curry? Is that what it is?
Sick. Yeah, I hope we get the truck there.
Dude, if the truck's there, that'd be awesome.
Yeah. After party at the truck, yo.
Free drinks on Rizwan. Oh man.
All right, let's see if Ducks can. Let's try to shrink the gap a little bit. If you can win this, I'll be huge. And Ducks under the jump beers.
I like it. He's backing up, but not too far. Doesn't want to get stuck in the corner again. There we go. Oh, come on, bro.
gotta confirm those.
Yeah, Maximus definitely has the firepower. He just needs to lock down his execution a little bit. He has the strategy down. Just need to be a little more patient when getting stuck. See, there's that damn ball into the corner again.
Yeah. And, I mean, fortunate for Color Technic, he put Maximus back in the corner again. Air to air.
He's like, oh, okay, let me get myself back in the corner for you. I'll make this game easy for you, bro. Let's go, Maximus. Damn, and it was 5-1, and it was looking like it was going to be 10-2. And all of a sudden, what do we got? 5-4?
Only
5-3.
No, it's 5-3. Okamoto Kitchen. The that tournament just finished last night. I'm gonna do a restream for it tomorrow morning. So yeah, if you guys want to watch some Kakadugo, I'll be doing an English stream for it in the morning. I'm trying so hard not to check the results. So no spoilers, please. Let me enjoy it while I commentate it. Anyway.
Wait, what's the name of that again?
Kakadugo.
What the heck is a Kakadugo?
Kakerugo.
Cock?
Here, I'm gonna type it in the chat. Kakerugo. And don't act like you can't read that. I know you know how to read.
Sometimes. selective reading skills.
Bro, I know your GPA was like one of the highest, bro. Stop lying.
I'm not gonna lie, my GPA was, it was shit. It was 3, 4, 5 with honors classes because I got kicked out of all my classes at one point for not having enough hours for ditching and playing too much Street Fighter. That's, I swear on that.
Your GPA in Hyper Fighting was too much?
Yeah, GPA was a little too high in Hyper Fighting, man. It was actually Champion Edition when I was early on in high school.
That's funny.
Oh, man. Yep, get expelled from high school. That's what happens when you don't go to school and you wind up at the Vietnamese bread store across the street, fucking every class.
Drop out of HS for HF.
I was an honors and fun mate, dude.
So you see these mix-ups here. So Color Technic takes the bite. Second time around, he takes a bite. Third time around, looking for the bait. Good mix-ups in. That jump short just goes right over low fear. It's really interesting the way that Maximus is timing it. But the bait again.
That's an excellent neutral roundhouse, too. Jump neutral roundhouse. Excellent. Round two. Come on, Maximus. You're like one game away from like stealing all
That's
the momentum here.
Three pieces.
Two fireballs.
Alright. Not the most damaging, and you lose, the knockdown, but it's alright. I mean, you still got corner. Maximus has got to be careful how he's throwing the fireballs. Now we're in the corner. Block a train incoming.
Patience, Danielson. Patience.
Oh,
just chill.
My goodness.
Oh, wow. So, okay. So, fuck the patience. Huh? All right, we got you.
The Ume Maximus, sure you.
First, you're calling him Minimus. Now you're talking good about him. I see how it is.
I see how this is a bias. You get the game.
You get the W's,
and I'll be throwing a hell of compliments out there.
What basketball team you like, bro? Let's hear it.
The Knicks. Nah, I'm just playing. Not
You're
really.
Like, oh, Knicks are winning now.
I haven't watched basketball in years. I used to watch basketball, in the 90s when the Bulls were the shit.
What's your sport of choice then? Cricket or what, dude? What's going on here?
Cricket.
No. Is it really? I'm just
fucking
around.
No. Actually, on my wife's side of the family, like her brother is on a cricket team and he's like almost pro level. They're in high school, but like he travels around and it's on national TV and stuff. So yeah, they take it serious. It's a very competitive sport.
Did you guys just see? I'm sorry. I keep talking and then distracting the match. But did you guys see how Blanka had him in the corner? Stayed about 40% the screen away and just jumped up and down roundhouse, and Ryu couldn't do shit. And you guys are still gonna tell me Blanka's not favored over Ryu in the matchup? Come on, dude. You guys don't see this? Look at the damage output.
I didn't see it because I was too busy thinking about cricket. But
too busy thinking about those those jock straps in cricket. I got you, dude. It's cool.
Oh, that's a stun. Let's hit that fireball combo. Let's get it.
Fantasizing about the paddle. We got it, dude. We understand. We know how you roll. Look at that punch, dude. Look at that. Two fierces and the match is even, dude. That was ridiculous.
Blanka wins this in HF. Everyone knows that. Damn. Now, I'll tell you what. I played Fromo in this matchup, and, like, I couldn't win at all. I was like, damn. But Fromo's kind of OD.
Fromo's pretty damn good. See, and he's not even playing you offline. If you played him offline with this Fro in your face, dude, it's over. Look at that jump roundhouse, man.
Call him Mo Fro.
Look at how much damage it hurt, and look how far he hit it from.
Oh, that's it. No, he missed his stand fierce. He could have done it, because he was standing. That would have stunned. But jump jab throw. Short throw and a 55. That's some old school strat right there. Three throws.
7-4. Still winnable. Definitely still winnable.
Respectable. He's got to get another three. Get that seven up. Yo, what's up, Nightmare? Yeah, shout outs to Fromo for real. If anyone's in touch with Fromo, tell him I miss him.
Man, see, you talking about like paddle boards touching Fromo and stuff. Come on, bro. Like, I don't know.
Oh, talking about side switch.
Wow.
Nah, bro, I'm just saying. Fromo's dope.
He didn't maximize that, but that was a great attempt.
Oh gosh, just got hit. Yeah, nah, you ain't getting out of that corner. What'd you think? You could jump short out of there? Nah. You're gonna jump short? Nah.
I really like the range that this Blanka's at, though. He definitely knows the matchup. Right? Like.
Yeah, I'm sure he has, like, on his monitor, he has, like, the guides. He just has, like, tape on his monitor that shows where he needs to stand.
Like, the kids would put a piece of tape for, like, headshots for, like, what game were they playing way back then? Gears of War or whatever?
Yeah, or, yeah, he probably has something like that where on the Honda stage on the tiles, he knows exactly where to stand to make that neutral jump roundhouse into the side switch ball work.
I think Colors is respecting the uppercut from Maximus a little bit more now, because this guy's busted out a few of them to win games, and just I want to say it's a good training method. He's training him to respect his uppercut. So here's the tough spot. This is the worst part of the matchup right here. Just stuck in the corner and
just gotta be patient.
Wow, nice spacing, super nice.
Yeah, so when you see those balls, the slow ball, you just sweep it. Don't try to throw it. Don't just press sweep, because it's gonna come out fast enough that you can punish him before he gets to tag you. And the good part is, if they do a fierce ball, your sweep won't even come out. You just block, because you're timing it in a way where if the ball whiffs, your sweep comes out. It's a good option select. See that trade there? After the delayed low strong to go into fireball, Blanka gets a sweep. Close to stun here. Still close to stun here. Not gonna get it anymore. Reversal bite. Got baited. But Maximus has a huge lead. Don't gotta be super aggressive right now. Just kinda maybe wait for a jump or wait for something where you can counter poke. Goes for the full stream walk up throw like a boss. I can't believe that worked.
He got him stuck in the backward block animation because he was holding back.
Hey, see that right there? He's trying to jump out of the ball, but Blanka will either get the bite or he gets that stand fear anti-air. So that's like Blanka setup. Oh, man, the stand jab gets blown up. This is going to be it. How do you come back from this? Blanka can trade for days. Gets a reversal bite anyway.
One way to come back from those. Back in the day, we called the referee. And when you say referee, that's when your two friends grabs the guy on the other side of the controller and holds him so he can't block anymore and he just win the game automatically.
That's kind of funny.
We actually called that the referee, dude. That was so funny back then.
Alright, that's a well-timed fireball. Now he's going to get the whole tree to work with.
This guy's getting away with a lot of tick grabs against Blanka. I don't know how he's doing it, but so far it's working for him.
Oh, that's it. Hit the three piece, please. Oh, he goes for the tour. Still got it. Deep pun.
There we go. 8-6.
I'll say 85 right there.
That's it?
85, bro.
Damn. Maybe I'm in a rush to get out of here. I'm sorry, guys. Old senile man. The Parkinson's kicking in today, dude. It's a little bit.
Low gap.
Take my mid.
Bolts a stun here, not gonna get it now. Nice low strong. Air to air.
Yeah, that jump roundhouse just gets you out of everything.
Should be it. Chip. No, not even.
Blanka's Blanka train still works. Round two, fight.
Yeah, that shit's never left the track, bro.
Dude, that stuff's pretty damn good. So once again, Ryu's stuck in the corner. I'm telling you guys, this is a bad matchup, dude. Like, I don't know why no one agrees, but this is definitely a bad matchup for Ryu.
Another 55. This guy knows lore.
Okay, so you're watching this match go down. I think these guys are pretty fairly even in skill, right? Mm-hmm. Do you think this match is in favor of Blanka? Like, after seeing the zoning, after seeing the jump roundhouse being put in effect over and over?
If you ask me personally, my opinion is going to be a little bit biased for two reasons. One, like, I'm not a hyper fighting dude. Like, I don't play this game like that.
Gotcha.
I know there are differences, and Blanka got buffed. So what I would have to think about is like how the game speed comes into play, and finally we got the max combo. There it goes. But yeah, between that and how the RNG, the way the damage is in this game has a higher variable than CE, and I don't know how much of that would actually play into, you know, the match overall, but. Anyway, that being said, I still give it to Ryu, but I agree it's you know not easy for Ryu. But for me personally, I still put this in Ryu's favor. Like Ryu should win it, but it's not easy.
Wow,
you think
Ryu should still win it actually?
Yeah, yeah.
I think at worst, at absolute worst, it's like 5-5 Blanka, and that's at worst. And I think it could get even better than that for Blanka, like easily.
And the reason why I say it is because, like, Blanka's definitely going to get in on Rue, right? Like, he's going to get in. And if you have a character that can get in at least once, then the match is no longer, like, one that favors the character with the fireball, you know, heavily anymore, right? Because, you know, rule of thumb in Street Fighter 2 is if you got a fireball, you're probably, like, going to beat the character who doesn't have a fireball. It's one of, like, the main characteristics of fireball characters. But... But because Blanka has at least one opportunity where he's guaranteed to get in and do damage, that minimizes, like right there, right? A fireball trading with a sweep given Blanka a setup. So Blanka's never out of it. It's a difficult match, but Ryu should still be able to control and survive. Like, he should be able to survive here. Just gotta be patient and throws out a shore, you Hail Mary.
That was for lifeline, dude. That was game over right there, right? It would have been
10. Yep.
Sick. Not the best choice, but the best results did come of it. Very ballsy. Gutsiest move I ever saw, man.
But yeah, I'd be curious to hear, you know, people's opinions in the chat as well. What do you guys think, Rue versus Blanka? Personal experience, what you're seeing, what you've heard. You know, I think it's still debatable. You know, I think this game has... There's a lot that could be debated because the max potential... There's room. Because stuff keeps, like, kind of evolving, you know, for the game. It's pretty fleshed out, but the nuances, there's still an opportunity.
You're not going to have Ryu activate, like, a V-ism and get his ass out of the corner and go corner to corner like Akuma in Alpha 3, you know?
It's
pretty straightforward, bro. Yeah. It's pretty straightforward. Like, if you watch, this guy knows his... Both these guys know their ranges, right? And like I said, I would like to think they're both pretty equal in skill, but this Blanka character in this matchup is just... I just think it's that much tougher for Ryu, where I think the score does reflect the advantage Blanka has. I truly feel like these guys are pretty even in skill, just from their spacing, just from their knowledge of the matchup. I think they're both doing good things on both sides, maximizing what they can at times. So
nice. Yeah, I mean, and that's it. With the KO33 emote, if y'all got it, it's a CPS1 emote as well, so it works out. Anyway. Yeah, I mean, my thoughts, though, as well, like, yeah, when it comes to talking about a matchup, people will say, yeah, if you look at it at this level, where if it's not 100% optimized, if it's like 90% optimized, the matchup chart's completely different, right? But if you talk about, like, if it's completely optimized where you're not making mistakes, it's just more like one person read the other player, but they're playing the matchup as best as you possibly could, then those numbers are the ones that hold the most, you know, weight and value, because that's like, if we're looking at it at the highest level. So we're already considering now there's like net play involved, and it's hard to anti your DP Blanka, for example, or it's hard for Blanka to do the right meaty setups and, you know, stuff like that. So when we talk about if it's not 100% optimal, then yeah, like.
So this is how I look at it. Offline, Blanka's not going to get tick thrown, right?
Yeah, and Blanka should not really get tick thrown by Rue.
And then Blanka like, shouldn't online, ever get jumped on offline either. His standing fierce is a very, very reliable option against a lot of the jump shorts and jump jabs that Maximus was doing. But also, Maximus would have the advantage in terms of he'd be able to uppercut on reaction a lot more, and I think they both would benefit, but like I said, they both know the matchup. They're both playing it well, considering it is online, so
yeah,
they both took advantage of the fact of that online has some lag, and they both used it to their advantage in the situation. So like I said, I really feel like both of them were pretty close in skill. They both knew the matchup decently well, and they were both playing pretty damn good, but I think the score really does reflect how Blanka wins that matchup. Whether you want to think it's really bad or whether you want to think it's close, I still think no matter what, it's in Blanka's favor. And just that jump roundhouse alone should show you, like, wow, it's really, really tough to do anything about it on or offline.
Yeah, because at a certain point, Ryu might have to pick the best spot where, at best, he's in a trade with it on something, and that's just the nature of the game. And what I found just, you know, hanging with the HF crew the past 2 years is they're still debating the tier list. They're still debating matchups. Characters that weren't utilized as much back then are being used now. And I know Blanka and Rue are popular characters, but there's still room for development of tech, because when we talk about the OG time where people are playing this game, where you guys are playing it, it's maybe in that 1 to 2 year time span where this game was it. And then new challengers came out and the alphas and everything else and kind of changed things up. Right. But now to look back at it 30 years later, I don't know. Like, I think there are still aspects that can be debated, and maybe we get to a point where we're like, all right, it's a pretty even match. But for me, for now, I'll, you know, have a contrasting opinion from you where I say, I still think Ryu's got it, but I respect your opinion as well, of course.
See, like I was mentioning, you know, like, Ryu, he can't force the action, you know? Like, he's forced to kind of counter whatever Blanka wants to do. Blanka's in complete control in the match. Blanka's the one, you know, he's leading the dance here. He's trying to punch you with fierces and trip you with roundhouses and jumping in, guessing fireballs, whereas all Ryu can really do is throw safe fireballs, hopefully, or low strong, and then maybe 2-in-1, maybe kind of, you know, try to push Blanka away a little bit. Because what are you going to do when you get close? All you're going to do is a low strong into a fireball to push him away. You don't want him close.
Yeah.
So it's like you can't force the action. It's not like where Ryu versus Dalsum, you get in and you just try to tick him and you try to stun him. It doesn't work like that against Blanka. You're at his mercy. It's a real slow, drained out match. And the problem is Blanka hits you hard, right? And when you're Ryu, you're not going to get too many opportunities to knock Blanka out. So you're working pretty hard as Ryu. People always say Ryu's scrubby, Ryu's easy. Dude, this match is tough because you literally have to play it slow, and you have to take your time and just pick your spots real carefully against Blanka, or else you're going to... like you saw it. He ate two fierces after having like a 30% lead. He ate two fierces, and yeah, it was an even game, and he won with an uppercut to finish it. I don't want to say it was lucky, but it's kind of like it became like a desperate situation there, and he clutched it out, obviously, but still wasn't the most ideal. And that's not talking shit. Maybe he knew it was coming for sure. Whatever the case is.
Yeah, I mean that's what makes the game. That's what makes the game, you know, fun and intense, is that it's wild enough with damage and RNG and things of that sort that it's really hard to have a consistent kind of this is the way that a matchup will always go. I think this match is more, I guess, predictable. For me, Ryu Gat is a time over match.
Really?
Yeah. Ryu Gat is like, what? So there's a difference in this game. Let's get that color swap. Yeah, there we go. So I'd say the difference here from CPS, I say CPS 1, but what I mean to say is Champion Edition, is Sagat's Tiger Shot in that version is much better for him to be able to keep up with Rue. And here, he's more susceptible to getting jumped on. So what that means is you have to be an even better, you know, fireball thrower with Sagat. But in Champion Edition, this match always ends in time over. And DJILK, he's a CE player. So he's going to play a very CE style, I feel like. And be respectful of Sagat's Tiger Shots to try to neutral jump them or go fireball for fireball. At this point, you got a life lead and you can kind of just drain out the clock and win the round. It's going to be a long set. And that's what Sagat has to do at a certain point. So if Ryu has a lead, the round is going to run on it's going to end on a Ume Shoryu, and Sagat, you know, and vice versa. Like, that's what they're going to do. The last second play is where the match really starts.
See, as a Ryu player, I like to walk up and, like, get in the range where I can low strong his low Tiger, and then if he doesn't stick out a Tiger, I want to be able to... I'm not a fan of doing low forward here. I think it's kind of pointless. I think you're better off doing a low strong and then low roundhouse, 2-in-1 fireball to push him towards the corner. Just keep him right here, and you can kind of do the Blanka strategy where you neutral jump once in a while to neutralize the little Tiger. If you jump straight up, you jab his jumping roundhouse.
Yeah.
I feel like Sagat's missing a lot of trip guards here when Ryu jumps. He has a free low roundhouse against Ryu from that range, so we'll see how the match pans out. I know they just started, so probably both warming up here, getting into the groove, feeling each other out.
And DJ going with a very aggressive play there, even though he had a life lead. At this point, timer scam is your best friend. Like, there's no reason to go in. If you can do a safe fireball where Sagat blocks it and you drain out like 5 seconds of the game clock, you're good. But yeah, as I called it, it's going to be a very... DJ, I think, is going to play it very CE-esque. And again, it's a little bit harder in this game. Sagat does have a couple of buffs in this game. One is his uppercut is much better. So you can uppercut like low forward a bit better in this game than you could in CE. His uppercut is a bit more buffed. In addition to that, his jab, strong, and fierce uppercut all knocked down. This is huge, so if you do any kind of like piano uppercut, you know, at least you're gonna get the knockdown. So those are a few buffs that he has. The Tiger Knee is slightly different compared to CE. I can't explain how, just looking at it, I know it's different. But I don't think it's gonna play too much in this match in particular. Tiger Knee is like not a big decision maker, I'd say, for this matchup in particular.
I think Tiger Knee is only necessary when you're going to start mixing up the 50-50s. Tiger Knee throw, Tiger Knee uppercut, just to, when you start going ham when you need to, or when you're feeling yourself.
And nice uppercut right there. H-Zero waking up compared to game one. And that is actually H-Zero's specialty. So when he does Tiger Knee throw or Tiger Knee uppercut, we actually call that the H-Zero. And at this point, yeah, just drain. Uh-oh. There's not enough time. Not enough time. He needs to Shin Shoryu. I mean, he tried. That was the most optimal thing he could have done and hope for the best, but another time over round. Also, what's up, Nerd Josh? I hope I see you are reloaded if you're going. There goes that low strong you were talking about.
Like, the only thing I don't like is, like I said, he's using low forward a lot. I would prefer to definitely do a low roundhouse 2-in-1 at this point to push him more towards the corner. The low forward's kind of... It leaves you at that awkward position where I think you're giving Sagat back, like... a zero neutral, like you're back in a 5-5 neutral position where you should always want to have like a little bit of advantage. So
essentially with that low forward, you want to make it so that at least it doesn't whip. If you can make him block it, then you know, you got to cancel the fireball, or like you said, walk up and follow up with sweep. But yeah, a whiffed low forward or low forward that gets you nothing afterwards on block is not a good look. There goes an interrupt right there, right? So H-Zero sees a whiff low forward and he feels compelled. Let me just fireball. If he does a fireball, I'll stuff it.
Very risky uppercut. I would have gone with the low roundhouse, but once again, that's why these guys are playing and I'm not. So.
And well, washed up Watts?
Bring it in 1-1. These guys are both. This is a. Like I said, you know, I don't want to talk shit about online, but these guys are playing at a pretty high level considering the handicap they have of playing online.
Yeah, and again, so this is so H-Zero is in Mexico, DJ currently on the East Coast. So I mean, their connection's holding up. It they don't look like they're missing anything. It looks like they're actually playing their stuff. It's not like, oh, missed DPs or, you know, if anything, there might be. There goes that fireball, the terrible recovery, and that's a stun. Finish him.
Very nice. I wonder what part of Mexico this guy's from. Any idea?
Nah, if Hakuto's in the chat, he'll be able to say it. I'm not quite sure, but Nice, got the jump around out in and blocked. He blocked all those toxins for some reason. Got it.
Man, the damage output, just people, man.
So again, at this point, like, H-Zero on the, a little too aggressive for my likings right now. He, there it goes, jump round outs, but still, risky jump round outs. He's, like, the life bar is not really as important as the clock is. If you have a life lead, you play the clock. That might be a stun. That's not. Yeah, sometimes jump round outs to raw Tiger Knee will stun in this game. But at this point, no need to throw unsafe fireballs or take any risks. H-Zero has a huge life lead. DJ is going to have to go in. Even if it kills 50 game seconds, like, he's still going to have to make a Hail Mary to make a comeback here. And H-Zero going fireball for fireball. Good defense. Calls out the Tatsu. And at this point, yeah, just don't throw any unsafe fireball. You see H-Zero playing a pretty safe game. DJ's got the corner. Let's see what he can do with it. Alright, 50-50 time. And an uppercut off of one stand short. Very nice.
Very, very good. Well, I'm impressed, dude. He played defense. Didn't blink, man. Just pushed him in the corner. He just held his ground. Very well played.
And I should mention that meaty stand short that DJ did, that would have got blown up by an unblockable uppercut anyway, whether he stayed in his face and did nothing, because a reversal DP from Sagat is unblockable. And so, H-Zero was still like, I have a huge life lead, let me just guard and see what happens. And, you know, he made the right call. Close to stun here. And Fierce. Alright, here we go. Now, one short too many. In the corner, that might have worked, but mid-screen. Not
doesn't
as consistent. DJILK
got those jump roundhouse hurricane combos down, man?
Oh, nice whiff punish on the sand pierce. Rare. Oh, he got it. And short throw. Wow. Danger.
These guys have no fear. Round
two. Fight. Even
what is, what's the prediction for this set? We're looking at what? 10-8 here? What do you guys think?
Well, let's see. For the channel points, everyone went with H-Zero. No hope for our see. Ah, oh, man, that could have been the game right there. That whiff Tiger Knee. That could have been the round for sure. So Ryu does have a re-dizzy against Sagat. It'll re-dizzy about 50% of the time, but it's pretty consistent. You know, first you got to get a stun. But he has two re-dizzy setups. One is off a cross-up, where you do cross-up, short fireball, huddo. And then in the corner, you actually don't even need a jump in. You can just do triple low short sand fierce fireball, and that will usually re-dizzy. Right now, DJ still going super aggressive. You can chill, like, he's still going in and super disrespectful, must say.
You want to play defense? You can play defense by yourself, buddy. We can get that perfect.
But I think that was a good time to shake things up, because now it's like, he didn't make H-Zero guess, like, shit, should I start uppercutting more? It's so scary, and I know Eggs and Bacon goes through this a lot with his characters, but that's one of the strengths of Ryu, is that, you know, the meaty crouching light kick. It's so scary having to guard it, because you guard one, and you try to do something on the next, they can just go second low short, sand fierce fireball. Like, it's a heavy mind game from Ryu.
Very nice jump around house.
And the anti-air.
I don't know if DJILK just turned the on switch on. I don't know if Troy's like just rubbing his back in the back like Little Mac gets rubbed by like it's coaching Tyson. But he just turned it on somehow, man. 50% life lead, and that's round.
Chip out, yeah.
Wow, what a huge swing in momentum. I think Hero got a little comfortable just playing defense and just a. Slowly getting the lead, and now DJILK's bringing the fire.
Well, you see what it is right here. DJILK is also playing a bit more patient. So he's been anti-airing a lot more jump-ins. And that's the thing. You don't see a lot of jump-ins in this match unless you're really anticipating a fireball or jumping a fireball on reaction, which Sagat can definitely do over Ryu Tato. Ryu a little bit more on the guessing side, but for Ryu, it's a bit harder, I feel like, to jump over fireballs. Sagat, you know, he's got those.
He's got some range on that one.
Nice low forward interrupt. Looking for a trade. Closest stun into stand forward. Saves him.
You win. Round three. Fight. Tiger.
Okay.
How do you get points, dude? I got 1.3k points, dude. What do I do with this?
Yo, you need points, bro. I don't know. You need to watch my streams more. What can I say?
Watch and earn points. What do we do here?
Alright, fireball. Short sweet fireball. And 8-0 with just a jab tiger shot.
You know, it might not go 10-8. It's probably going to go 10-9.
Maybe, yeah. I mean, the way that they're playing right now. But let's see. DJ, it looks like DJ switched up strategies and to play the clock as a life bar, and that makes sense. That's what you got to do. Yeah.
I feel like this timer goes by a little fast. I don't know, man. Am I that long out of the game? It really does seem like the countdown's a little bit quick.
It's fast until the last 10 seconds, then it feels like an eternity. But I think that's just the nature of Street Fighter.
Right.
Yeah. That's just the nature of Street Fighter. Like, I was talking about it on another stream. I only look at really the first digit, and that just tells me how many seconds I have to actually make my next decision. So, when the clock is at 99, I'm like, alright, I can chill for like 9 seconds before I actually gotta do shit. And when it's around the 80s, kind of same thing. So when the clock's at 30, you're like, yo, I only got 3 seconds to really decide how I'm going to close out this round. And,
I like the use of the high tigers here. This guy's hit a couple of hurricane kicks with this, hit a couple of jump-ins with it. Very on point with the high tiger. He's going to push to the corner.
Wow. That Shoryu is kind of clutch. Short throw. Danny DeVito throw, I don't know. Sure. There goes the mix-up.
That's where Ryu has the advantage here. Once he gets in, it's a world of hurt.
Yeah, A0's gonna have to start throwing out some tiger uppercuts, because that's, you know, again, Ryu just being point blank like that is really just taking advantage of the fact he has the corner. But there, yeah, blow up those shorts, yo. Don't let him have those. Don't let him have those.
It was going in straight, no lube, no respect, man.
Hit him with the 8-0. Touch
it up.
Stand short? No. All 8-0 needs, yeah. Just at that point, yeah, stand short, low forward. Those are your best friends. Don't throw any heavies. Don't throw any fireballs. Just finish him with the easy stuff.
Take zero chances. So who are you rooting for? Who are you rooting for, Riz? You got 8-0 in this match?
It would be nice for H-Zero to win, because he's kind of been out of the game for a minute. That might be a stun. It's not. Nice wait there from H-Zero as well. Yeah, H has been out of it for a bit. At one point, he was like the most dominant Street Fighter 2 player online, I feel like.
And this is on Fightcade, or was it on one?
Fightcade. But like, because we were doing a number of different events, and then Mexico had its own league, and he was kind of like just killing it on everything. Nice Shoryu. Hold on, let me wait till the end of the round. Oh no, didn't get the fireball cancel. What's it gonna be, player? He jumped in and a guard. Tiger knee and the Shoryu blew that up. Oh man, that was critical.
That was a great ending.
But yeah, let me, obviously I want the match to go to distance. I want it to be 10-9, but I want A0 to win because I hope it gives him that boost to come back and do more of these events. There's a certain point where he kind of just like fell off of it, and I mean, for good reason. There goes a re-dizzy.
Beautiful.
Works 50% of the time, I'd say. But hyperfighting will probably stun more so than CE. But yeah, the point I was going to say is, it'd be nice for A0 to come back, because at one point he was just entering everything, winning, and then he kind of just started his own streaming on the side and organizing stuff. But yeah, we need
what are these
back.
Guys? What are these guys' real names?
I don't know.
No one knows?
I mean, I knew it, but I can't tell you right now. At least for A0, like, I'm sure I knew his name, but just call him H, bro.
So
I think
H
it's like
might be for Jorge.
I think it's like Umberto, I think. Don't quote me on
Dude,
that. But
we're getting all racist. I'm thinking it's Jorge. You think it's Umberto?
Well, I mean, because I think that's his actual name. From what I remember, it's been a minute. But DJILK, not sure.
Definitely not a... It's been a long day, guys. Sorry if not too talkative today.
We got the tame Watson.
Tame Watson's not the fun Watson though.
Are they desynced or what? What's all that about?
I saw a little bit of lag here and there. I don't know if it was for everybody or what was going on earlier.
I don't know. They press start. Okay. All right. No, I guess we're good.
Round one.
Sorry, Loraldo. We gotta get our jalapenos and yak in the box correct. My bad, dude. Who's conceding, Nuxukao?
Tiger, do you throw? Oh, almost had the whiff punish there, but DJ gets one of his own.
Yeah, so do you play Sagat at all? You play Sagat at all, Rizwan?
Who, me?
Yeah.
I mean, in CE, I'm going to play every character, but in HF, I just play, like, Rue and Bibson, I guess. Oh, and Ken. Yeah, I play Ken in every game.
Ken in every game. All right. And the blonde white boy. Gotcha.
But Sagat's cool. I mean, Sagat's fun because you're kind of trying to turn it into a one-player game where you're like, can I throw perfect fireballs for the entire round? You know, that's really what Sagat wants. Sagat players take pride in throwing safe fireballs, essentially, and then sneaking in unsafe fireballs by conditioning. This might be it. Yeah, see, 50% of the time, fellas. 50% of the time, they'll re-dizzy.
Round three, fight!
There goes your statistics. But nice follow-up from DJ, because he just went for walk-up, crouching light kicks. They'll trade pretty much with anything that Sagat does after that, and you get to re-dizzy anyway. And Choi coming through with the XL macros now. Empty jumps. Going for it, looking for a whip punish, doesn't get it. Yeah, too far for Tiger Knee punish. Gets a clean Shoryu, or uppercut rather. You just call it a Shoryu from now on. No anti-air sweep. Alright. I think we lost Watson. I think Watson fell asleep. I'm out. I'm too tame. Yeah, 3-5. I feel like these guys have been playing for a minute. Close to stun here, not gonna get it. Yeah, I don't know. I feel like stand short is a great button from Sagat in this matchup. We haven't seen A0 use it, considering that he's an old Sagat player in Super Turbo. I'm surprised he's not utilizing it a bit more here. It's a good poke. Got the uppercut. Tachibaki. Short throw. Short. Got him. Disrespectful. Big jump, got the two-piece, and that's a stun. Huh. Oh, he still went for the combo. I would have done the CPU. Whiff jab twice and throw him. Screw it.
Round two, fight.
Alright, jump roundhouse. Alright, A0 staying alive out of the corner. Nice. Still in the corner though. Gets a clean uppercut. Let's get some pushback here. Forces the pushback. Got the jump roundhouse. Uppercut on the Tiger Knee. Short. Big jump. Tiger shot. Try to walk up again. Not gonna get it that time. And A0, he's also not going for like neutral jumps on the fireballs. Content with the blocking, but one of Sagat's strong suits is the neutral jump on fireball, because you're going to keep that fireball on the screen for a little bit. And Ryu's not going to be able to chuck another one, so he's going to go for a random Tatsu. Shout out to hashtag random Tatsu channel on the Hyperfighting Discord. If you're not there, do !HF to get in there. Random Tatsus. And that's a Jurgen's uppercut right there as well. Got the throw, and we're looking at a 4-5. The Jordan comeback incoming. Got him.
All right, this is looking good again. K Can you hear me, guys?
Welcome back. Welcome back.
I don't know what's going on. We're here. We're here to stay. Yep, you guys have too much technology to play with nowadays.
Nice little strong ground starter. Oh, Tiger Knee that, please. Only gets the MK. Mortal Kombat punish. Got the Tiger Knee throw, though. Oh, he missed a big jump around out there, but it's alright. No uppercut.
Where is the anti-air when you need one?
Got him. Oh, that wasn't even a combo. It looked like he just interrupted. Oh, what? And the Tatsumaki Senpukyaku gets him out of trouble. What are you? Oh my goodness, that was so far.
That one hurt for sure.
Yeah.
Round two, fight!
Nice uppercut after whip sweep. Short sweep Hutto. Stand short, finally, thank you. Please use that more, H-Zero, such a great butt. Short throw. And that's it. Oh, he missed the chain, commentator's curse. And H-Zero's got a chance to get a 5-5 on Cinco de Mayo. Please, let's get one of those.
What time's your dinner reservation, bro? You might not be making it, dude.
Nah, I'm good. I'll be all right. I knew that we were doing two sets today. I didn't know this would be the second set. And so, it's all
right. You would think if there's no sim involved, it'd probably go faster, right?
Yeah, but no, Ryu Sagat, I told you. This is a freaking battle of the clock. Oh!
Oh, no.
Oh, he missed a big chance there.
Dude, I can't express to you how happy I am to see Jump Roundhouse air to air, though, man. That's so, so far gone in any of the newer games.
I have to show.
Great
to
see it.
Show.
Yeah, he said you have a date with five guys tonight, bro. Is that confirmed?
No.
No?
So Jump Roundhouse is one of the lost arts?
Dude, Jump Roundhouse air to air is definitely a lost art from Hyper Fighting. I don't even think people did it in Super Turbo often.
Yeah, Jump Roundhouse got a little bit nerfed, I'd say, in CPS. Well, after New Challengers. Like, New Challengers still good, but...
You don't eat the beef, Riz? Is what they're saying true?
I mean, yeah, I have, you know, very strict, you know, dietary restrictions, I guess, so...
I got you. From what I recall, you're a pretty slim dude, right?
Not anymore because of the damn pandemic. Uh-oh, what's 50-50 gonna be? He took it! Oh, what all the SPD damage! And no Cinco de Mayo, we don't get it.
He did take it.
So unfortunate. I mean, I should mention that the actual stand short is also throwable, of course, but like, you know, ideally you just want an uppercut, right? You see Rue in your face, you're the Gat Man. Your uppercut's gonna blow up any meaty anyway. The only thing it won't blow up is if Ryu does a dragon punch of his own.
I think I'm probably gonna panic low short Tiger Knee. If they're walking forward, fuck it, dude. Hell, marry that dude. Right? I mean, at least you get a combo out of it. If you don't, you get to whiff and you put yourself in a 50-50 situation, and Ryu's probably kind of in shock. Like, why is he in my face closer?
There goes the Tatsu punishes that Ichiro's been pretty on point with. Respectable.
I'd like to see a little more neutral jump straight up and down from H-Zero, if he can get in close, but otherwise, I feel like the spacing. And he's not doing too many low roundhouse for anti-air. I think he missed a lot of opportunity on that, but overall, everything else is really good here.
Nice straight, stand medium kick. Yeah, no, I completely agree. Neutral jumping Ryu's fireball is pretty big in this match, and it gives Sagat, you know, what he needs to sway the momentum. Oh, he missed the combo. He still got a two-piece. That might be a
stop. Wow.
Yep. Oh, I got to tell you about that, because I don't know if you guys were doing this back in the day, but you see how DJ is able to jump back on every Tiger Shot? So if you do a meaty Tiger Shot on Rue or Ken, they can hold up back. It doesn't matter how Sagat times it, they're able to, they don't have to block the Tiger Shot. So you just do up back on wake up and meaty Tiger Shot will just keep going. The only problem is Sagat can walk you, like he can push the wall and eventually you'll land into the Tiger Shot if it's a slow Tiger Shot. But in this game you also have Air Tatsu, so it's just a mix up, but basically meaty low Tiger Shot's not legit in this game for the most part, except the corner. It's only Shoto's. So you see right there, DJ used that jump back. Only Shoto. For some reason. No.
What are you? Dude, he's getting some meaty uppercuts on this guy.
You win. Round two, fight.
Long day.
Dude, my day started like 4 a.m., bro.
Damn.
I only work 7 days a week, and on Friday, Saturday, Sunday, I'm on call 24 hours.
Shit, when are we gonna record the episode, bro?
Shit, but I keep my eyes open and not look like a fucking zombie on screen, maybe.
You don't gotta be on camera. We don't do cameras on Super Lore Boy size.
I need some makeup and a... figure this out real quick. How do you hide wrinkles, man? Is there some new tech?
Yeah.
We'll get some Botox.
Get a pedicure. Get your hair did. I've been listening to Missy Elliott again. She's on point. Nice uppercut.
If we do audio only, dude, people might think you're interviewing Kermit the Frog, man. You gotta have some face to go with it.
What's that, the Kermit the Frog Star Wars meme?
Dude, I just like the Kermit the Frog where he's like just minding his own business, you know? Like, I could be wrong. Just drinking his tea.
I like how you just make fun of yourself like that. Damn, at a 5'7".
Hey, man. As a grown man, you gotta be confident in your own self. So, it is what it is.
I mean, to be fair, I hate my voice. I don't listen to any of my own crap. It's like, kind of cringe. I don't know how you do it, but...
The most successful talk show host in the world, what, Howard Stern? And look at him, dude. He looks like a fucking... some anorexic, like, tall, lanky... goofy ass looking dude with a shit voice, and he's the most popular in the world, so.
I don't know how Howard Stern is still doing stuff, but yeah, I remember he was pretty big in my childhood, late night TV stuff.
Oh, man.
Yeah, exit.
No more
right,
stories of the old days.
Oh, that's a stun.
Why bacon? You know you want to hear it. What? Two fireballs? Oh, where's the uppercut, dude? Don't get lazy.
Yeah, a little too slow on that.
Pretty cool. Let's get two fireballs out of it. Not bad. Practice your timing, you know? A little bit greedy there. Tried to walk in and grab. Didn't work. Uh-oh.
Funky trades.
What kind of trades?
Funky.
Oh, I thought you said monkey. What the hell does that even mean?
No, funky.
Funky. Got it. Got it. Just like, you know, what were you saying? What was the name of that Super Turbo match? Cock something? I don't know what you're talking about.
Get out of here. All right. 6-7.
Making sure. Testing these old ears. My new hearing aid just came in, so just making sure these batteries are the right ones.
It's your headset, bro. Your headset.
Dude, Joe Rogan's the man, dude, but he has a lot of views a lot of people don't agree with, so I don't know. What's up, Tron Bomb? Hey, dude, just ask anything in chat, man. And when there's a lull in the action, which there's not too much lull in the action tonight, both these matches are really sick.
Yeah. These guys are, yeah, this is definitely... I mean, last week we had good matches as well with Choi and Eggs, but this is... Yeah, I'm having fun. I'm chilling.
You know, you're not watching Deep Focus here, you know, getting ripped up, so... There's a lot of action going on.
I heard about that. I didn't get to watch the match, but I heard about that.
I heard Korea's greater than the United Kingdom, at least for this week.
Ooh, got a jump roundhouse.
Oh man, we don't have any stories back in. We didn't go to any bathhouses back then, the Laraldo. So I don't know how to relate. You know, maybe talk about like some high school gym class stuff. I don't know.
And DJ is still bringing out the dirt. Wow, look at that.
Dude, this guy plays like just straight up. I don't give a fuck, dude. I love it. I love it.
I mean, he's confident, and it shows because he's able to do these walk-up, you know, anti-air uppercuts. But yeah, I'm surprised that A-Zero is not chucking out more Tiger uppercuts, because he's usually pretty clutch with those. I don't know if it's rust or just, like, fear. I mean, right there, like, he's getting blown up on his own empty jumps. Nice bait right there. Only gets a jab, Tiger shot. Here we go. This is a much better round for both of them, actually. No one's been put in a scramble yet. Plenty of time left on the clock, and that's it. Boom, boom, clap him real quick. Got him.
Very good.
7 up. We got ourselves a classic first to three now.
Looks like your wifey and kid are gonna be eating dinner a little bit late tonight, bro. And it's not my fault this time.
I gave myself a buffer, so like I'm good.
Right on. So what'd you tell him? You're gonna eat at 8 and then you're gonna come out at like 7:15 and be a hero?
Yeah. No, I'm just gonna end the stream just like the Alpha 3 thing that happened earlier today. Right when they finished the last match, it was just boom, stream turned off. We're like, what?
What Alpha 3 thing happened today? The one in Japan?
No. So in France at HFS, they're doing a big Alpha 3 tournament tomorrow, and they did an Exism only East-West battle. So they had like two teams go head-to-head, Exism only, and it was dope. But then right after the last match, it was just like they just turned off the stream. I thought my internet went down. But anyway.
Dude, you guys want to hear about some horrific luck? So. I don't know if you guys know, before you start, is it
what kind of story?
It's nothing, you know, pornographic. It's nothing sexual or anything. It's a Street Fighter story, bro. Come on, man.
Go.
There's a Street Fighter stream. You gotta know where your stories go. So I don't know if you guys know the story of B4 where I had a boom mic stuck in my face.
Oh.
So me and Vire playing grand finals of not grand final winners finals of Super. And dude, I always hated like taking pictures. I always hated media. I just don't want to play the game, you know. I don't care about recording. Get your damn shit out of my face. Let me play, you know. In the middle of winners finals, I'm going to do a tap with Balrog for chip damage, and a boom mic coming through the side of a showcase cabinet literally hits me on my nose. What would you guys do in that kind of situation? And you're playing for a trip to Japan, like the dream trip of your life. I pretty much have to win Super Turbo because I'm not going to, like, I'll place high in other games, but I'm not going to win Marvel. I'm not going to win Alpha 2 or 3 with Choi there. I'm not going to win Third Strike with, like, Shin Chang there, right? So ST, I have to win that to qualify. And you get a boom mic in your face when you're trying to clutch it out and go to Winner's Finals. Like, it's ridiculous, dude.
Yeah, that match is still up on the tube, actually, and they show, like, match had to be redone because Mike got punched in the face or something.
Right? Like, that's so stupid. And it kind of sucks. Vi was on fire that day, and that was, like, it was a super good chance to beat him. And then in the end, I think I was distracted, and then he felt bad at the same time. Like, we're friends, you know? He wants to see me succeed, but he also wants to win. So it was kind of like one of those things where it's like the match after is not 100% from both of us.
Yeah. It's weird because
it's one of those unfortunate events, you know? All the momentum, all the gas is just removed from Zank at that point. But that's not the only situation. So we were at Midwest Challenge one year, and we're in the grand finals again. I think it was me and Vi again. And I don't know who was winning at that point. I just remember the power got shut off in the middle of grand finals.
At the venue?
At Super Just Games in Northbrook, Illinois. They turned off the damn power. Okay, so that's not the end of my bad luck. I don't know if you guys saw the video I posted where I was rocking the van on a road trip. But we were playing, and it's also winner goes to winner's final. It was me versus Shirts. The cabinet shuts off in the middle of a match. So I've had like three funky incidents like in finals of Super Turbo, dude. It's just, what a curse, man.
Well, you
incredible.
Said funky, right?
Funky.
Okay. All right.
With F.
Yo, you're learning. You're picking up some of my vocab. Good stuff. But
F is in fuck you. You like how we can say that? We can say fuck you, but we can't say other things. What a weird world. What a funky world.
Eight up, fellas. But I don't know. You got some bad luck. It reminds me of I don't know if you're aware of that one. What was it? Ultra Street Fighter 4 match at Evo Grand Finals where Gamer B had all the momentum and then his stick went out. And after
they couldn't even figure out whose stick was broken. It was a Razor stick, right? It was him versus
Momochi.
Momochi, there you go.
Yeah, that was such a sad, kind of like end to the tournament because the entire momentum just shifted, and you can even see like Momochi's kind of response to it after he won was just like, oh man, like, you know,
like you want to play someone and you want to beat them at their 100%, you know, or else the victory is kind of meaningless.
Cause like whatever happens to you personally in the day doesn't matter. Like, when you're playing a fighting game, actually a lot of that stuff just completely leaves you, but stuff that's in the game that happens in the tournament, that stuff will affect you. It's super weird. Like, you could be having a bad day but still playing good. Like, that stuff will not change how you were for today. I don't know how to describe it, but like, it doesn't.
Hey,
like,
but you know what?
Like that, like a joystick was bad or a button went out, that shit will affect your mental game for the rest of the tournament.
Like, but you know what, man? That. To be fair, he was playing Elena, and that character is such a fucking cunt with that healing shit, bro. So whatever happened, whatever made him lose is karma, dude. Fuck that character.
Yeah, Elena wasn't a fun character, but anyway. Right now, DJ looking to go up 9-8.
Uh-oh.
And he goes up 9-8.
Let's go, oh, Mexico. Boy. Come on, bro. Do it for all the taco vendors in your hood. Right, everyone had a goddamn pocket Alina. That shit's stupid. I hated that game, dude. I never touched that game. There's that low strong. Uh-oh. Had him shoved to the corner right away.
Got two P's in the corner. This might be the last one.
H-Zero's tigering. Tigering his way out with some timely stuff. Get a tiger, need to get some space. Throwing some safe tigers here, watching out for the jump in. Pretty sure he has that tiger uppercut on deck right now, waiting. But you got DJILK here. He's a very smart player. Backing it up, backing up, giving a little space, milking his lead. Uh-oh. It's about even right here.
Ugly trade, but H-Zero takes a lead.
Well, there we go. Sweep. Finally, we got a low roundhouse anti here. Okay, H-Zero has to play really safe here. Probably going to see a random spin kick pretty soon.
Yeah, hit him with the helicopter.
Surprise.
Hit him with the helicopter. He needs it.
I like these tigers matching, wasting space. Uh-oh. Wow, what a perfect.
He needed that round. Wow. Clutch.
Both of them with the low sweep. Back and forth. What a match.
The Chin Chang Kobe story. Alright, so we got another story. I don't know. We're close to the end of the set, though.
He's like, I want to go to dinner, guys. Can we tell these stories later?
Alright, so Blockbuster John, now that you bring it up. So, you know, eventually, at one point or another, very soon, though. Oh, nice answer. Double MK. He's going to take a big chunk of life bar. Look at the Tiger Knee combo, too. And backs off. Doesn't want to deal with the Tatsumaki. But yeah, we are going to get Mike on an official podcast and talk to him about some real OG shit. And it'll happen. I know everyone. Like, I feel like, you know what it is, Mike? Like, a part of you has been with everyone in the scene where they have a very specific story. Because anytime I got you on the commentary now, there's people that jump in. Yo, tell this story. Tell that story. Like, everyone's got, you know, an interesting story or an encounter with you. And, you know, that's what makes you a good storyteller.
And real quick, I know it's Cinco de Mayo. John is actually a true Mexican, so happy Cinco de Mayo to you, brother.
I don't know
the And here
on
we go.
One.
Last right. game of the set. What is this, the 19th game? Holy shit.
Yo, game 19, a ragtime coming through, but it's up. Appreciate. Told you, this shit was going to go to distance.
Right?
Tiger
I
shot.
Called the I changed it to 10-9. Whoever doubted me, go eat a funky whatever you want to eat.
Go have some Five Guys.
Nah, I'm not gonna promote that. I'm sorry. Yeah, don't go have Five Guys. Leave
go
that to Tara Reid or someone.
What the Evo promoted Chipotle, right? Go have some Chipotle. Esports.
I can't promote anything Evo promotes either. I'm sorry. You're gonna have to go somewhere else. Pornhub, guys. Website of choice for the evening. When you're lonely at home, when you get stood up.
Come on.
Nothing
are we gonna get a random uppercut?
Lick yourself.
Is that a draw game?
Whoa!
Oh,
Ryu
DJ.
With like one pixel lead. Sick. Alright.
DJ definitely had some Dr. Pepper or something. I don't know. Got that.
No, Riley Reed is low tier. Alexis Love is still the best.
Wait, are we still talking hyper fighting?
Yeah, sure. As long as you got a monster grip, you can make it hyper as long as you got a big grip. Alright, guys. Looks like we're coming down to the wire. H-Zero's gonna have to force a pretty big comeback here. I highly suggest some more Tiger Knees to get in than the Tiger Knee uppercut to get things started here.
So here's the thing. There's plenty of time left on the clock. Yeah, you just gotta play clean. You can't take risks. Nice. Tagged him on that. This is like super doable right now. You got the fireball. That's what you don't want. You don't want to lose.
One uppercut would have took the lead right there. Oh,
that would have been it. He still got it, though. He's got the corner. Uppercut that. Big boy damage. Let's go. Oh no, you missed the safe jump!
No.
Oh no, terrible jump.
A double missed input right there, and the round is over. Hey, you guys played awesome if you're listening. That was a sick match, very entertaining. You guys both showed a lot of gall, played good offense, played good defense. It's really well played. First set, you guys also played awesome. Blanka Ryu matchup. Thank you for entertaining all of us. Thank you all for being here tonight. I know Rizwan has to grab some dinner. We'll tell some stories next time, but
yeah, nah, good shit.
It was fun. We'll be back here again. Thank you all for supporting the channel. Thank you all for keeping the games alive. Thank you all for being all polite. And yeah, just keep the games alive, guys. If you have any questions, feel free to ask next time or join us in the Hyperfighting Discord chat. And we'll leave it to Riz1 to tune you guys out. Have a good weekend, guys.
Yeah, Mike blessed me with the early exit. But yeah, I gotta close out a little bit earlier tonight. Tomorrow morning, I'll do the Kakerugo, the restream. Where the hell is it? This tournament just happened during Golden Week. Of course, we'll let Mike troll in the chat all he wants right now, since I'll be the only one talking. But yeah, come through to 37 Reloaded. It's like about two months away now. It's gonna be a fun tournament, I promise. You know, Watson has a lot planned for you guys, and whether you play the games or you don't, it doesn't matter. It's gonna be a fun, memorable event. So you guys should definitely come through and chill out. I'll do the restream for this in the morning, so tonight there won't be any more streams. It's gonna go out and chill. GG's to everyone in Hyperfighting. Shout out to Mike for, you know, coming through the commentary. Tell some good stories as well, everyone in chat who hung out. And of course, Eggs and Bacon for getting everything organized. The players are all awesome and good shit. But before we go, you know, I gotta get off the jet. Of course, we got the gang as per usual, and gonna find someone to raid. See y'all. See y'all in the morning, I guess. I mean, I don't know. See, what are we gonna watch? I don't know who we're gonna watch. Alright, Makai Cup. Yeah, watch the Makai Cup. They're doing Vampire Xavier, and they're gonna be doing ST as well this weekend. So there's Vampire Arcadia. Oh shit, wrong command. So there's Vampire Arcadia that's running tournaments. Then HFS is doing tournaments. Of course, there's Fight Kingdom this weekend. There's a bunch of retro to watch, and I'll try to keep up with as much of it as I can. And yeah, catch y'all later. What's up, fellas?